Hi, this is Anil from Learning Lad and welcome to the Guess the Output video series on C programming language. In this tutorial, you guys can see a C program in the screen. First, you have to find whether this program contains any errors. If you think this program is error-free, then you need to find the output of the program. To do this, you guys can take your time. You guys can pause this video. Once you guys have an answer, you guys can play the video back. I'm gonna run the program and explain the output. Now you guys can pause this video. Alright, now I think you guys have an answer for this program. I'm gonna build and run this. So the output is, in the first line we get 227, in the second line we get 343, and in the third line we get 0343. Now if you look at the source code here, we have the integer variable x and we have stored some value in this variable x, and then we have three printf statements, each displaying the value of x in different formats. In C programming, we can represent the integer data or integer value in three formats. One is in the decimal format, or you know, in the base 10. Second one is the octal format, or in the base 8. Third one is the hexadecimal format, or in the base 16. When you're writing the integer values, if the first digit of your value is 0, then the C language considers that that value is represented in the octal format. If the first digit is 0, then the C language expects the remaining digits of that value to be valid octal digits, or the valid base 8 digits. In octal number system, we have 8 digits, 0 to 7. You know, we can have any digits from 0 and 7. And if we have the digits like 8 or 9, then they are the not valid octal digits, or the base 8 digits. So here, the first digit is 0 in this integer value. So C considers that this value is represented here in the octal format. So it expects the remaining digits to be the valid octal digits. And in this case, we have 3, 4 and 3. And these are the valid octal digits. Now, what happens if we have the digits 8 or 9 here? You know, they are not the valid octal digits. So we're gonna see that later in this video. Now, we have stored this octal value 343 in this variable x. So this is not the decimal value 343. This is the octal value 343. After that, we have the printf statements. In the first printf statement, we are displaying the value of this variable x. And to display that, the format specifier that we have used is %d. This %d will display whatever the value given to it in the decimal format. So here, this x variable is containing a value in the octal format. And this %d displays that in the decimal format. So in the first line, we get 227. This 227 is the decimal representation of this octal value 343. So x is containing the octal value, but because of this %d, it is displaying the value in the decimal form, or in the base 10 format. Now in the second printf statement, we have %o. This %o is used to display the values in the octal form. So this x variable is containing the value in octal form, and here we have the %o, which displays the values in the octal form. So it will display 343. But one thing you have to see here is it will not display this leading zero, which is the digit denotes that this is the octal value. So it will not display that digit 0 here. Okay, in the third line, we have the printf statement. And here, as a format specifier, we are using %o. Now we have already seen that when we have %o, it displays the octal value. When we have this hash in between the percentage and o, it will include that leading digit and it will display the octal value. So in the third line, we get 0343. This 0 is the digit which is denoting that this value is the octal value here. So that's why we get the output like this here. Now, what happens if we have a digit like 9 here? this 9 is not the valid digit in the octal number system. So if I try to build and run this, we get the error. If I open up the error logs, it says invalid digit 9 in octal constant. So here we are specifying a octal constant, and this 9 is not the valid octal constant. So that's why we get the error. So this is it, guys. This is about this video. If you like this video, hit the like button. If you don't like it, then hit the dislike button. If you want to say something, then write that in the comment box. If you want to watch more tutorials like this, then do subscribe. If you think this video will help any of your friends, then do share this video with them. Thank you for watching. I'll see you later in the next video.